In our seventh episode of 10 Questions, we're going into space where no one can hear you scream. And we're going to test your knowledge on one of the greatest freaking sci-fi horror movies ever made, the first Alien. So, can you go toe-to-toe with the Xeno? What's up, guys? Happy Alien Day 426. Wanted to strategically drop this on the exact day. And this is the seventh episode of 10 Questions, so you think you know. If this is your first episode, how this works is I'm going to test your knowledge with 10 questions, multiple choice, on any given horror movie. And for this episode, we're going to do the very first Alien, 1979. So all 10 questions will be from that movie, not any other movie in the franchise. Of these 10 questions, you're going to have really, I guess, four levels. You get a easy, medium, and hard, and then the last question will be a challenge question. So I'm gonna ease you into it, okay? The last episode for The Shining was a doozy, probably the hardest episode yet. I don't think this one's gonna be as bad. But there's some nice questions in here for you guys, okay? Keep track of your scores, hit the pause button if you have to after each question, and post in the comments at the end of it how you did. And let's have fun with this, okay? So anyway, I'll see you at the end of the quiz, and good luck. Question one, the success of what film led to Alien being greenlit? Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Empire of the Ants, Star Wars, or The Andromeda Strain? Answer, Star Wars.
I don't know that there was a consensus one way or the other about science fiction. I mean, since I was the responsible party for making Star Wars and it was such a hit, concerns about science fiction went away very quickly.
They wanted to follow through on Star Wars, and they wanted to follow through fast, and the only spaceship script they had sitting on their desk was Alien. So they greenlighted it, wham.
Question two, what is Ripley's first name? Grace, Ellen, Eileen, or Joan? Answer, Ellen.
I could tell that Ridley wasn't pleased, but he was again behind the camera. And as we walked away from the master with the group of all of us, Ridley suddenly turned to me and he grabbed my hand. He said, look, I don't want to give you your motivation to pick up your fucking teacup. And I went, and I burst into tears and I ran off.
Question three, the Nostromo's original name was the blank. The USS Sulaco, Ranger, Scorpio, or Snark? Answer, Snark. Question four, who's the artist responsible for creating the Alien? H.R. Giger, Dick Smith, Roger Castell, or Bernie Wrightson? Answer, H.R. Giger, of course.
He was very strange looking, dressed all in black, you know, this Swiss accent. And when we were looking at his work before we met him, we weren't really sure we wanted to meet him. You know? We were kind of disturbed about, is he really going to be here? You know.
I like if they are disturbed. Yes, that's good. I hate if they don't look at it, or I have people, they like my stuff, or others, they hate it.
Question 5, how much screen time did the alien get in the movie? 10 minutes, 8 minutes, 6 minutes, or 4 minutes? Answer, 4 minutes. Question 6. What famous actor turned down the role of Captain Dallas? Michael Douglas, Harrison Ford, Robert Duvall, or Donald Sutherland? Answer, Harrison Ford.
When I read Alien initially, I wasn't drawn to the project. Ridley wasn't attached. It was, my understanding was going to be a $2 or $3 million budget on it. And I thought, well, you're not going to make an effective film for that. And about a month later, I got a call from England, one of the producers at the time, and told me that Ridley was going to be directing it and that there was a budget that would realize the potential. And then it became something else. It became working with Ridley Scott, learning about filmmaking.
Question 7. How much was Sigourney Weaver paid for Alien? $35,000, $45,000, $55,000, or $65,000? Answer, she was paid a whopping $35,000.
Ash? Open the door.
Oh, yeah.
Question 8. Who played the alien? Wilt Chamberlain? Don Kohler, Tony Todd, or Balaji Badejo? Answer, Balaji Badejo.
Well, the casting director had been standing in a pub and had stared at this guy who looked like probably close to 7 feet, right? And very slender, very thin, kind of elegant, and his name was Balaji.
They built the suit to him, which was, it was just unbelievable. I mean, his hands were below his kneecaps. He first gets me. He's in a down position, and he comes up and rolls out, and oh, it was just so creepy.
Question 9. What medical disorder inspired the famous chest burster scene? Angina? Pulmonary embolism? Crohn's disease? Pericarditis. Answer, Crohn's disease.
I don't want to talk about what it may do. I'm eating this. What's the matter? The food ain't that bad, baby.
You choking?
What's wrong?
Challenge question. What was used to make the tendons of the alien's jaw? Bubblegum? Shredded condoms? Macerated tire rubber or stained plastic? Answer, shredded condoms. Ew. Well, that's it, guys. How did you do? Post in the comments. Let me know your scores. Also in the comments, let me know some suggestions for the future. I definitely have our first sequel, Halloween 2. That's going to be coming. It Follows. We're going to be doing that one. Maybe Lost Boys. We'll see. But let me know some suggestions in the comments. So anyway, guys, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day. And on Fridays, we do Free For Fridays. Follow me at Drum Dums on all my socials. Support me on Patreon. Buy me a coffee. Happy Alien Day. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. And Drum Dum out.